ng gulong today kasi upod na yung isang gulong ko. So dito sa SMS. Try ko palitan yung isang gulong upod na. Today, namatay yung sa relatives namin. One of our relatives died. Tito Boland was the brother of my father. I think second to the eldest, that means Tito Oye. So, it was very sad kasi close sila ni Papa. And, we'll go to Manila today and visit last wake ni Tito Boland to fill up. So yes, today is December 2 na. December 2 na, bilis magpasko. It is the season to be jolly, but sadly today, we just learned that Tito Boland, my uncle, passed away a few days ago. Good thing, Mama, that the Jeturians were able to gather up the siblings one last time with Tito Pito, Tita Mirna. The last two siblings, three siblings, were able to meet. The De Leon siblings, my dad's brother and sister, they're able to meet here in Santa Cruz last November, and it was too bad I was not there. I was in the office. It would be moments like that where you should have time, give time, basta give time, kasi nga next thing you know they already passed away. So my Tito Boland, my Uncle Boland, who works before in Japan, then got married to a German girl named Tita Sabina, and had two kids, Suzanne and Dennis. The most memorable thing I recall was when they visited here and we went to Baguio with them. And that's the first time we have met cousin Dennis, who's now in California, if I recall. Dad and Uncle Boland is very close to each other. As you can see with the pictures, I can insert them. Give a short slideshow of my Uncle Boland with the siblings and together with my dad. It's another loss in the family. You really have to cherish all the people around you, man. And it's a good thing we have those kinds of reunions to go back and reminisce what we had together, even for a short period of time. May you rest in peace, Tito Boland. Hope you have a nice life there in heaven. Be with Lolo Temiong, Lola Alice, and to Oye, and of course my dad. And we will go there to his wake today in Manila in QC. Sad day. Fudge! Oh my god, fiesta na dito Santa Cruz, Immaculate Conception, December 8th. So that's why the Ferris wheel is already here. And the stalls are already here. Grabe ang bilis na setup nila, ha? So if you see these stores beside the road here in the Philippines, it's a sign that there's a fiesta. And our fiesta is the Immaculate Conception, just in front. That's the Mary Immaculate. So in every town in the Philippines, we always celebrate fiestas relating to the patron saint of the church.
the wires are already showing worst case, not to like. Oh, look at that. It's still able to run though.
Dangerous. Do not ride. Anyway, new tires na si Benz. Time to hit the road. Kita-kita ka lang kung ano. As usual, likot ang mga bata. Ayan o. Ayun. Sige. Likot. Likot. Ang dami na kami sa Manila. 4 o'clock na. Sa Sunday drive. Sunday driving naman kaya. Stopover lang kami dito.
We all will be together.
So it's very handy, you see. This humidifier we just bought this in Singapore. Very handy. Ganda. Ang bango. Ang likot ng dalawa. Hoy! Ang likot nyo! Tigilan nyo nga yan! Hag! We're here na sa Santa Rita Parish here in Quezon City. Ayan na, kung saan nakaburo si Tito Boland. So I'm gonna eat first muna. Customary sa Philippines to have the wake 7 days or a few more days. Kain muna.
Bye-bye.
Ingat, Tupito. Bye-bye. Go, Rosie, bye. Tito Boland. Tito Boland, isa siya sa handle the repatriation between the Japanese government and the Philippine government during World War II. So yung repatriation, yung mga gastusin and damage, sila yung nag-handle, si Tito Boland. They were stationed in Japan
to handle all damages being done by the Japanese government during World War II. They are the ones handling it. So they included my father and all of the brothers, the Leon brothers, because all of them are lawyers. So they handled everything. Maybe I'll search for it. So Tito Boland is like the ambassador in Japan who handles all those. Pakita ko sa inyo yung clips, black and white. During their stay in
1935,
Japan.
1935,
ang birthday. Birthday year. Nagkamali daw.
Hindi alam ni
Dennis. Nagkamali lang ako ng 1 year. 1934 lang. Tito Boland married the German girl named Tita Sabin. Yeah, Tita Sabin will be coming on Monday and Tuesday for the burial. I'm gonna end the snippets of the vlog. The snippets of the pictures of them in Japan. Usually in the Philippines, whenever someone dies, ililay muna siya sa coffin. So we don't usually cremate. So if he's laid down in the coffin for like 7 days and for prayers, and then last rite would be going out to the cemetery, ilalagay na siya, ililibing na. But in this case, Tito Boland will be cremated sa Arlington crematorium. Yay! Vlog! Says she's also doing vlogging. If you like to check her channel, ano ba channel ko? Wala pa. Sa Facebook lang pala niya pinopost. So pwede ka matulog dito. Oo nga, channel ka na. Bye to Tito Boland. Tomorrow, Dexter will be here. On Tuesday will be the cremation and burial, the crematorium. So we're gonna leave now, going back to Santa Cruz. There's the dawn. End the vlog here. Subscribe to the channel. Bye-bye. Tito Boland. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on the upper left and on the lower right. Peace.